Hello everyone. Today our topic is forensic investigation. So let's dissect this topic in complete depth. The word forensic investigation comes from the Latin term forensis, meaning of or before the forum. The history of the term originates from Roman times, during which a criminal charge meant presenting the case before a group of public individuals in the forum. Both the persons, the accused of the crime and the accuser, give their arguments based on their side of the story. The case would be decided in favor of individual with the best argument and delivery. So this was all about the history of forensic investigation. Now let's understand, what is forensic investigation? Forensic science is a critical element of the criminal justice system. Forensic scientists examine and analyze evidence from crime scenes and elsewhere to develop objective findings that can assist in the investigation and prosecution of perpetrators of crime or absolve an innocent person from suspicion. Investigators will look at blood, fluid, fingerprints, residue, hard drives, computers, or any other technology present at crime scene to establish how a crime took place. A forensic investigator usually locates, examines and processes physical evidence at a crime scene, which prosecutors may use in law courts. Forensic investigators can do this by looking at evidence from multiple sources including textile fibers, foreign particles, paint, bodily fluids and fingerprints. Nowadays, there are a wide range of disciplines within criminal law, which forensics can fall into. Some examples include murder forensics and assaults, DNA forensics for sexual offenses, firearms forensics and ammunition, forensic fire investigation and arson. Principles of forensic investigation. There are 7 principles of forensic investigation. So, let's discuss them, one by one. First, the individuality principle. It is regarded as the building block for forensic science. Individuality implies that every entity, whether person or object, can only be identical to itself, and so is unique. No two objects, whether natural or artificial, can be exactly the same. The aim of forensic science is to focus on the source of two items questioned and known, or mark and print, which are thought to have come from a single source. As such, identification is concerned with establishing individuality from traces left at a crime scene rather than the sameness of two things. This means identification can be shown individually through the analysis of traces and samples. For example, no two fingerprints are the same. Second, the exchange principle. The exchange principle is attributed to Edmund Lockwood. The principle states that whenever two objects or subjects interact, some sort of trace will be left behind. This is generally what happens at the crime scene. Trace materials include hairs, blood, fibers, gunshot residue, etc. Lockwood suggested that there are many traces left behind, and if interpreted properly, they provide most valuable information. Third, the law of progressive change. Different objects change, although they may change across different time spans. For example, blood samples will eventually degrade. Some objects are more durable than others, and be relatively permanent, remaining mostly unchanged during identification. If an object is very durable, it may be quite easy use for identification. It is quite less permanent, and its main features change during the identification process, and thus it won't be possible to answer the question of sameness. Fourth, the law of comparison. Different samples must only be compared to samples which are alike. In other words, blood samples are compared to other blood samples, fibers are compared to other fibers. Fifth, the law of analysis. The quality of any analysis determined by the quality of the sample under analysis, the chain of custody, the expertise of individual who analyzes it. Sixth, the law of circumstantial facts. If a witness testifies that he saw a defendant fire a bullet into the body of a person who then died, this is direct testimony of material facts in murder, and the only question is whether the witness is telling the truth. If, however, the witness is able to testify only that he heard the shot and that he arrived on the scene seconds later, to see the accused standing over the corpse with a smoking pistol in his hand, the evidence is circumstantial. Seventh, law of probability. All the identifications and identities are sometimes consciously and unconsciously correct based on circumstances. Law of circumstantial facts. Facts never lie, but men can lie. Facts cannot be wrong, it cannot lie, it cannot be wholly absent. Few applications. 1. Examination of physical evidence. 2. Administration of tests. 3. Interpretation of data. 4. Clear and concise reporting. 5. Truthful testimony of a forensic scientist. For example, mobile phone forensic investigation, forensic examination of computers, email fraud, data theft or leak investigation, Wi-Fi forensic investigation, Wi-Fi network monitoring. So this was our lecture for today. If you liked the content, subscribe, like, and share the video.